Suddenly, a shadow fell over me. I glanced up and saw Ava standing right beside me, her hands on her hips.
"I heard all about your date with Harvey last night," she spat, clearly not happy.
What had she heard? That we talked all night? That we had a good time, but as friends? Or had she heard about how we fought Shadow Fae side by side? I really doubted that. "Oh, yeah?" I asked, wishing she would leave me alone. She dropped her arms and balled her hands into fists.
"You kissed him, you bitch!"
I stood up at that, appalled by her statement. "I did what?" She snorted.
"Now you're trying to deny it? You're really a bitch!"
Oh, she was getting on my nerves. "You're the bitch, Ava. Everyone in the academy knows it." I didn't have time to react. She punched me in the cheek. My head snapped to the side, and pain spread over my face. My vision darkened. Holy shit. That was it. When I turned around, I came unloaded. I landed a nice punch to her chin.
"Stop it!" Claire yelled.
The rest of the students in the cafeteria took notice and surrounded us, but my focus was on Ava. She advanced on me, coming with her fists, but I spun around and struck her with a beautiful side kick to her waist. Groaning, she stumbled back, but only to come at me with a series of fast roundhouse kicks. I deflected most with my forearms, but holy shit, that hurt. She backed me up against a table and ended up kicking me in the shoulder before I was able to duck under her leg and get out of the corner. Meanwhile, Claire and Harper screamed for us to stop, Stella and Ruby laughed, and the rest of the students cheered us on, joking about bets. I faked left, and she fell for it. Then I did a series of fast snap kicks, a roundhouse kick, and a back kick, hitting her in the chest and pushing her back. On my fourth kick, she grabbed my leg.
"Hey!" I yelled. That was so damn low.
I was going to jump up and kick her with my other leg, making her lose her grip on me and land probably on my side on the hard cafeteria floor, but before I could do that, arms closed around my waist and pulled me back. I thrashed against the firm hold.
"Stop it," Ray said in my ear.
Instantly, I stopped fighting. A few feet from me, Harvey held Ava. With his arm tied against my waist, Ray dragged me outside the cafeteria into the cold weather. Without my jacket, I shivered against him. His hold only tightened. In silence, Ray took me toward the courtyard with the blackthorn tree. He wiped a wooden bench clean of ice and snow and pushed me down on it. Then he knelt before me and stared at me, his gray eyes, almost silver in this gloomy day, rummaged over me, taking in every inch of me, searching for bruises. His eyes fixed on my cheek. He reached up and ran a thumb over the bruise there. I flinched, not because he had touched me, but because the tenderness quickly became pain again.
"This is going to look nasty later today."
He lifted his eyes to mine.
"What the fuck were you thinking?"
Though his question wasn't nicely phrased, his voice was gentle. I shrugged. I wasn't. At the time, I was only feeling furious with her. She was the one who punched me first.
"Let me guess, because of Harvey."
"Why else?" I snorted. "Everything she does is for Harvey, and to impress his parents." Ray sat beside me, a good foot between us.
"What about you? Are you trying to impress Harvey too?"
I frowned. Was he really asking me that? I wanted to lie to him and tell him I was in love with Harvey and that he confessed to me and we would get married someday, have several beautiful babies, and live happily ever after. But I couldn't lie, not to this extent, not to him. So I said the next best thing. "It's none of your business,"